Whatever it is, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, all ages, colours, races, how are we doing?
I have hiccups, I'd be warned this camera may be a bit jibby.
Why?
Because I have hiccups.
okay, right, the RX-8 is in the booth now. You guys have heard me talk about quartz stuff like all the time. So now we are mixing the quartz primer. I spilled a little bit.
That's just a tad.
Yeah. Fucking like messy. Oh, that label's gonna come right the fuck off anyway. Ooh. Dump it over there. So yeah, and what we're doing is obviously we don't need build on the RX. We just need to seal it. So we can smash some fresh paint onto it. It's gonna look good. It's gonna, you know, we seal anything that's happening underneath that we don't want to come through. Yada yada yada. So what we do is we take the primer and we mix it 4:1 as it states, and then we reduce this fucker by 30%. So it then becomes a sealer. And if you look, I mean, obviously we're mixing this fucker now here, and you'll know when it's mixed.
Such a messy puff.
I know, you know when it's mixed because it's all silky like that. See how that's all nice and silky? That's mixed. That's done. This is all sloshy. So this isn't done. I need some bigger mixing cups.
These hiccups are making this video quite interesting.
That's cool. People like interesting. So we're going to continue mixing this. We've got our Dupont plastic adhesion promoter up there because we've got side skirts to do. The rear bumpers, anywhere that the plastic's exposed and whatnot. So, I mean, excuse the mess, we've been so fucking busy, but I've just not had time to do anything. Like, my flake gun is there apart. I've got to clean it, which I'll do once this primer bakes off. So it won't take long. We've used fast thinners in this, 15-20. We've got a medium hardener, because obviously we're lucky enough to be in a booth. So, and I'm going to dump this through my PRI. It will still go through my, for fuck's sake, it will still go through my PRI. That is my designated primer gun. So we're going to get this mixed, get me AirFed on, get in the booth, and show you how well this shit covers. Okay, so now Jakey's going to give this a go. Woo! Look how fucking, this is still obviously drying a fair bit. But I've let him have the mask, my baby and everything. So we can still see it's splashing off a bit around here. See? Because back here, we don't have anything. See how perfect, sorry about the fucking lines, it's these damn lights. But you can see how perfect this is. Do you know what I mean? So, still flashing off a bit, but the plastics are done.
Just for the camera.
They're coming to take me away.
baking off ever so slightly. We only did one coat, didn't we? So, first time with the AirFed. You've used the PR a few times, didn't you? And whatnot. So that means you would have used the quartz a few times. Give us your general rundown.
I think that time I used it, a million times better than before. And if it's a gun setup or what, but like watching you do it as well, the coverage on that.
Yeah, I know, we need to spend a bit more time together in the booth. I think definitely get you up to speed.
Yeah. I covered really well. I think head limit down a bit more.
Well, we need to create a sealer. I'll speak to Chris because I've been asking for a wet on wet sealer for a while now. Well, the thing is, because we do this on every, so whether it's having a colour change or not. The thing is, if you just scuff up panels or wet flat panel, whatever, and then put a base coat directly over it, it never looks mint. It never does. Whereas if you can just lay one coat down, you know what I mean, give it a 30-minute flash, get in there, and then fucking lay your colour without having to go in there and, like, we'll have to get some 600 now and scuff all that up, make sure it's all nice and smooth, which won't take long. But quartz will have everything. Oh, I was going to tell you something, and I forgot. Obviously, I spoke to our flake wholesaler, the company that made the flake. They will allow us to rebrand the flake under the King of Custom series. Because they do minimum of 5 kilo orders, because obviously they're a manufacturer, we can rebrand it. They said we're allowed.
Yeah, I'm in there.
But I want to get on eBay, order a few different flakes from popular sites and candies from popular sites, and then I want to compare them. I think that would be fun, and then we can show why the stuff we use is the best.
Yeah, let's do it.
Alright, time to flatten the fucker down.
Motherfucker, standing next, it's lovely and fucking warm. Okay, so we've baked this for 20 minutes at 60 degrees like you would normally. Obviously it's dry. Not that much to dry, it's cured. Okay, and you can tell that because we always wet sand. Once you rinse your pad off, there's no residue, there's nothing left on the pad. So that's how we can tell it's cured. The reason we want to show you this little boring section is just because of how good this fucking quartz primer is. Obviously you can tell this is what we've done, this is what we haven't done, right? So the quartz, the primer, the black primer becomes its own fucking guide code. So, literally, I mean, we're on 600 wet block, obviously. And mind you, this is literally just, it's just cooled down just now. We're in here because it's lovely and warm.
Yeah, so, 20 minutes and it still ain't cooled in down inside the booth either, so.
Yeah, it's fucking lovely, isn't it? Absolutely lovely. And if you don't know, when you are doing panels like this, obviously it's always best to crisscross your pattern. And then pump the bottle up.
I'm having a wank.
Yeah. And then rinse off and look.
No residue. Clean.
After just 20 minutes baking. Now, this is the other thing with wet flatting, which we like to do as well, is that. So, as you can see, we're all masked up, we're all degreased, we're all clean, ready to rock. I'm going to be using two guns for this one. I've got my SRI Pro Light, which is for all the door shuts and the little intricate bits I've got to be careful with. And then obviously my big normal GTI Pro to do the main body. So we've got all the plastics are going black. And obviously the body, we're doing all the three-stage stuff on. So it's time to crack on. First attempt failed trying to balance this camera because I'm on my own. It didn't even fucking focus. Oh, I'm pissed right off of this. So I'm going to hold it and try and do the best I can while spraying the second coat.
All the time,
This is pearl. Let's have a go at the fucking light a minute. Yeah, see? That's love. So, I mean, yes, it's like a candy, but it doesn't behave like a candy. You know, it's not got the strength or the depth or anything like that. So, this is what's left over. We ordered a litre, which we knew we could mix and get a very good coat down, which we've done. I don't want to put any more on because I think it'll change the tone too much, especially when we've got some sparkly to go on. There you go, look at that. See it just in there? It gives a bit of sparkle, but it gives a beautiful tone, which will match the one coat that we've done of this pearl. So that's why I don't want to go, fucking focus. So that's why I don't want to go too mad with it. So look, see, fucking rushing around on me Todd. Right, let's mix up some FX. So you're now gonna be, please, you can come closer, you don't have to stand all the way back and look. All right, not too close, so it makes me look fat. So, okay, well, your brother is where?
In bed.
In bed, because he's exhausted. Trying to keep up with me and failed miserably. So introduce yourself to all my fans and followers and everyone else on my YouTube channel.
Well, my name's Will.
William!
Helping out with some of the recording.
And hopefully more media share.
Yeah, helping out with some media, some of the videos, some of the uploading. When it comes to cars and stuff, I'm just an average Joe. I don't have a clue what's what. So,
which is good for us, because you can ask questions that other people out there in YouTube land might be wondering, might not want to ask.
Exactly.
So, but right. So now I can finally record the finishing stages of the paint job on the RXA. We've laid down the black metallic base, we've laid down the red pearl, and now it's time for my favorite shit, my favorite schnizzle. This is, well, everyone in YouTube knows, like, I've got a thing about flakes, candies, and like iridescent pearls and stuff like that. And I'm pretty much the only one down here that knows what the products are, because everyone uses shit from eBay. They don't research it, it's all dog crap. They flake a car, it looks like horse shit. We flake a car and it looks bloody amazing, because I spent 6 months researching just my metal flakes. So I know what the best flakes are on the market. And why they're the best flakes. I like having lots of tech around. Ooh, I got like, look, and yeah. See, I've got all my candies, and I've got like fucking flake, iridescent pearls, and whatnot all over the place. I always keep loads in. That's like an iridescent rainbow pearl. That thing's shit hot. But yeah, man, I've got like bags everywhere. But we're on the RX, we are putting Lightning FX. Now you will remember, look at that. See, it sparkles, but if you look on the bottom of the thing, it gives a tone as well.
Mm.
That's what makes it so cool. And we did, like, this goes well over like a Hellra orange. Now we did that on that dickhead's RX-7. And we've done it on a few orange things, but this is a proper custom. Like, the guy sort of gave us a rough idea on the colour, didn't have the money for candy, so this is what we've come up with, and he absolutely loves it. So it's always good as well to measure your products, because we're mixing this, it's probably gonna be a little bit too much, but I'd rather have too much than not enough. So if you measure your pearls, measure your flakes, you can get the exact quantity every time you mix it. So, which also makes it a damn sight easier when you come to, if they have a crash or a scratch, you can match it. You see? So it's all very excited, isn't it? Right, that's about 10 grams in there. Well, I always keep another pot. We want more than 10 grams in this. Oh, look at that. See that tone now on the top of that? Cushy gravy. I think I'm gonna put you don't need a lot of this stuff at all. You really don't, for it to pop. So we've got about 10 grams give or take in there. So, and this is the XB155 binder coat again, people. Remember, it's the one that's got polymer in it. It's the one that helps the direction of the pearls and the flakes when you shoot it. So I think we might need a little bit more than that. Okay, so we've got 10 grams in there, which is fine. But I think we need a lot more. I don't know, it's alright, what's your take on that, do you reckon? I reckon it probably needs a little bit more, to be honest. It's not. I reckon it probably needs, well, let's put 10 grams in the other one. So we know we're on point with our measurements. that. So that's 10 grams in that one. And I reckon we need another 'cause you don't need a lot of this stuff. See how that transforms now? That's gorgeous. There we go, that's what I wanted. Right, okay, yeah, so now I know. Okay, so the, for the perfect amount, I can guesstimate now with it. There we go. Whew, it's going everywhere. Right, so enough talking. I'm gonna get this mixed up and then we're gonna get in the booth and we're gonna fire it all over this RX and then cut it out. Okay, so we've tapped everything off. We've got the Pro, well, the FS all mixed up. The gun is set up, right? So now we're gonna start spraying.
Yeah!
the old thumbs up to say we're ready to rock and roll. Do you think I've got a quartz problem? But then I have developed that, and I have developed this, and I have developed that. This is my stuff. So, okay, clear coat time. And I want the best of the best. So we've laid down the metallic base, the red pearl, the lightning FX. It looks fucking gorgeous. And now it's time to seal the deal. So I am of course reaching for my liquid glass. So 2 to 1. And we're gonna fucking put loads of this on. Now this is the best clear coat on the market. There is no ifs, there is no fucking buts. It's got crazy UV absorbers, crazy high solid content. Just ask the boys on the spray painters forum. The reason it's called liquid glass, well, you should know by now, it's fucking incredible. Absolutely nuts. I've gone for the standard, not the fast. So I've gone for the standard on this job. There we go. Off the gun. No ifs, no fucking buts. Liquid glass, products from Spray Guns, and of course my guns, my DeVillBiss. And this is what you get. Having a little play, having a little imagination. You can have stuff like this. Sheer awesomeness. Real custom paint. Done in-house from a few ideas. He's going to be one very happy customer when he sees this. Fucking hell, I would be. But there you go, another one done. Right, let's bake it.